What's up, everybody? Mr. OG Games here, and today I'm finally able to get the factory up to level 26, so that way we can get some of the bigger boy cannons going. So I wanted to bring you guys along with me, that way we can do it together. And then, of course, after that, that was the first one I wanted to bring up, like I had mentioned in previous videos, just because of the back row cannon. And then, of course, I'm going to focus on getting one camp to 26, and then I'll follow suit with the others. And not only that, but it'll be time to level up some of the smaller buildings inside the city. So with current situations in the nation, as you know, territory and things like that, we've discussed it, and resources have trickled in, but I finally got enough, and I think I have enough to do a couple batches of the cannons afterwards, just to get myself a little bit of a head start. So let's go ahead, let's get it upgraded, and we're gonna sit here and wait about 3 days, 15 hours, 49 minutes, and 41 seconds together, okay? So just grab a seat, let's sit, and let's wait. Oh, hell no. I wouldn't drag you guys through that, and I'm not even gonna drag myself through another minute of it. So let's go ahead, let's speed it up. Let's see, I think that's a good chunk of those. I really don't care. Let's just go ahead and burn up all of those. Why not? Burn up those, burn up that. And there we are. First factory at 26. Now, let's get some recruitment going. Now, as I had previously told you guys, I wanted to, of course, I'm going to get some death tanks, but you know the strategy that I'm going to play. I'm not going to recruit a whole lot of those at all, but my first deal is going to be the uranium cannon. I need it in the back row. OG needs to be stronger. So we've done it. We've done it. Now, I can't remember how many speed ups I have for recruitment. Oh yeah, that's right. I've got a shit ton. Good God, I've got a lot. Yeah, I've saved up quite a bit. Reason I've been saving up, because I've been saving up resources to do some building upgrades, and kind of put troop recruitment on a little bit of a hold. So I think we can go ahead and use a couple of the 14,765 5-minute speed ups that I have. Yeah, I think we can spare just a couple of those. So there we go, our first cannons. Let's see what we get as a reward. Oh yay, wow, big reward. I would have loved to have some minerals in that. That would have been great. All right, so I've only got another 52,000 minerals. That's it. I mean, I've got gold to buy some, but am I really gonna do that? Probably not. Right now, if we look into our events, strongest commander doesn't even start for another 3 days. So here's what I plan to do, is to get as much uranium and steel, you know, and resources that I can get. So when strongest commander comes, we're gonna try to see what we can do in recruitment. Probably not a whole lot, considering I only have one building at 26, but we'll give it a shot. We'll see what we can do. So let's go ahead and just get a few of these guys going. I want to get them in the march, or the fleet, and I want to get them as quickly as possible. I know that this isn't gonna make a whole big difference until I can fill enough in the back row. Now, of course, when you're throwing T9s in with my T8s, I've got a lot of other troops to do, excuse me, besides just these cannons to get things where I really want them. But we're going to take advantage of, you know, we've got to get started with it, right? So that's what I'm doing. I'm glad I saved up a lot of these speed ups, and I know I shouldn't be doing a whole lot of them right now, but this is going to be the last batch. As you can see, my minerals are going to be depleted pretty much from here. So at least that gives us a good little start. Good little start. So I wanted to bring you guys along for that. Now, as far as looking at the others, as far as the camp is concerned anyway, with the T9s, that's going to be the elite infantry, which I do use, as you've seen in my setup, but I don't, you know the numbers that I use. I don't need to review all the numbers here. The Berserker for that mid-range troop is going to be on point as well. And then, of course, the workshop, once we do get that up to 9, that's going to be more so where I'll focus for the mid-range for the attack there. And then, of course, the back row. I've seen some people not really use these shielders a lot. I personally put a certain amount in, and it actually does pay off from what they can bring. And we'll definitely be getting involved with that. I know their attack is not as good as the cannon, obviously. If we take a look back at the cannon, their attack, well, I guess their attack is about the same, maybe just a touch, but it's the way that they're set up and how they're used in the battle is what makes that a kind of a big difference. So that's the plan, though. Right now, I've got the one workshop up. I am going to go with the camp next versus the workshop, because I want to make sure that I have my front row at their strongest peak as well, because front row in this game, more so a meat shield, but it also is going to provide more than just that protection. It's going to give a lot more structure to the formation that I'm going to need, since I'll have to, and I always will, pair with my highest tier and my second highest tier for the right formation. So I'm gonna go ahead and focus on the camp next. And as you can see, it's not gonna be that big of a deal to get that up and going. It's gonna be more so me getting the resources. I have called upon the mighty OG's twin farm to get things ready. We can get an abundance of steel there, food and wood. I've been saving food and oil. Sorry, I've been saving like crazy. So that way, what my plan is to do is go ahead and open up all those packs, hit that, and that'll supply me with enough food and oil for a long time. I've got plenty over there. This account, my main account, will focus on minerals. My farm will focus on steel. And I think we've got a little path in which we can take. As far as our equipment is concerned, I've just about got enough to where we can go ahead and start to get into our next piece. As you can see, we are only about 15,000 away from that. So a few days left, and I'll be able to raise my next piece. And I believe I am going to go for either the reactor. Hold on, I want to break it down a little differently. The reactor or the apparatus. And I'll probably go with the apparatus just for the long range attack. But I do like the max units in this one as well. So it's going to be tough, but I'm probably going to go with the apparatus just because of the long range attack and jumping that up. So that's going to be my next focus, other than continuously focusing on building up these T9s and finally being able to execute a little more power than I have been playing with in recent months. But yeah, that's about where we were at. And also one other thing that I'm gonna get leveled up as well, and that's the garage. That is gonna bring me some more max units as well. So getting the resources for everything. As you see, I've got the speed ups for troops for days. Building speed ups, not so much, but speed ups really don't bother me as much as just getting the resources that I need for everything in the order in which I want it. So stick with me. We're going to get there. And I think, like I said, this next Strongest Commander event, I'm going to hopefully be able to have enough resources to go ham on some troops and get the T9 cannons up and at least put them in the march. Or the fleet, so that way they can make that big difference that I need. But as always, if you guys like the video, smash the thumbs up button, and if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. And until next time, y'all keep gaming, and I'll see you in the next one.